Okay, nodes and antinodes. So let's solve this problem for waves on a string. Now I'm going to tune this guy all the way back down to 13. Where it was set up to be resonant initially. And there we have the lowest frequency that we can get. You can see that the frequency is lower here. This is the lowest frequency with which you can produce a standing wave pattern. If I tune off that frequency to something like 15 or something, you don't really get much of anything. If I go back down to 13, though, it likes that, and we get a good, nice, flappy standing wave pattern. So what's happening? We have a wire stretched between two fixed points. Those have to be nodes because, you know, they're nailed down. And so the pattern with the longest wavelength is this one. And so if this distance between these two is L, that corresponds to the total wavelength, lambda over 2. Why? Because to go through a full cycle, you'd have to go up and then down and then up to 0 again, way out here at twice the distance. The reason we draw it like this is what the string is doing in time. It's just flapping up and down sinusoidally in time. And the amplitude depends on where you are along the wave. And that's how we draw this. Now, if we had a long, infinitely long string with a certain tension F in it, and the string has mass per unit length, using more advanced physics, we could find that the velocity of waves on that string would be the square root of the tension divided by the mass density, the mass per unit length. Now we know that the velocity of any wave is lambda times the frequency, right? Something that should be deeply etched in your mind now. And so we put these two equations together and solve for the frequency. We find that it's equal to 1 over lambda times square root of F over mu. This is just a constant. This does not change, right? The velocity of the waves, in this case, is not changing. Velocity of the wave on the string. Now we don't really use the velocity to calculate these standing wave patterns, but we can relate the frequency that we get to 1 over the wavelength like this. Well, that's interesting. There is a lowest resonant frequency at which you get a standing wave pattern, as it turns out. And of course, you know, this is the longest wavelength pattern you can get with two fixed points, two nodes in it. You can't get any longer than that. What happens if you make those fixed points longer? Then you just don't get a standing wave pattern. Okay, so using that equation, let's do a third clicker question here. So if we shorten our string from length L to L over 2, keeping the tension the same, however, what happens to the frequency that we would get, given that the frequency is proportional to 1 over the wavelength? A, you get 4 times, B, twice, C, it stays the same, etc. Talk to each other, you have a minute.